Hey, what's happening, class? How you guys doing on this Wednesday? I believe it's Wednesday. Yeah, it's Wednesday. You guys, make sure you're doing your work because I'm already entered all the student grades. So if you did the work, I'm giving you credit. If you haven't, please, please, please do the work. Find time. I know you guys have time to do the work. I mean, I have time to do all this stuff. So please, 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 por favor. All right? Is that cool? All right, man, because it's math time. So how do we do this one? This is where your homework. So remember, you could always pause it whenever and just do it. If you're doing it with me, that's great. All right, no problem. So go ahead and do it. So what do we do here first? Okay, well, you should be doing distributive property, right? If you have done the arrow before. Or the box. I like doing the generic rectangle because then I don't mess with the signs. 6 times x is what? 6x. 6 times a negative 2 is negative 12. Bring down the positive 5 equals negative 7. Now what do? I combine negative 12 plus 15, which I could do the t-chart. Negative 12 plus 5. Which is negative, and it's negative, what, 5, 6, 7, equals another negative 7, right? Then I'm going to do 0 pairs. I can't divide just yet. I have to add 7 because I want to isolate the variable. So that's a 0. And then what I do on one side, I do to the other. Bring down the 6x equals 0. So I divide by 6, and that's a 1, and x is 0. All right? Another one is exponents. Well, I'm going to take the number 5 over 15, and I'm going to simplify it. So my answer is going to be a fraction. So 5 over 15, I could divide by 5, and I get 1 over 3. So I'm going to put that 1 over 3. Got it? So far, so good. All right, and then what up? Yeah. All right, so now here there are x to the 15 over x to the 10. So we're going to be subtracting. There's more on top, so my answer is x to the 5. Okay, if x 15 was in the bottom, then it would be an x to the 10 on the top, the numerator, then it would be x to the 5 on the bottom. All right, so far so good. Ooh. All right, now you had to do this. Okay, so what's figure 0? Well, it's y equals mx plus b, correct? So your starting point is 3. So it says, what's the pattern for the given equation? Create your own. So I'm just going to do 3 circles, very simple. All right, and then the change is 2. For every figure number. So 2, I'm adding 2. 1, 2, 3, and then I'm going to add 2 on top. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 2 on top, and then I'm going to add 2 more on top. Okay? So then what am I shading? What am I shading? The 2 on top. The 2 on top. So plus 2. Okay, that's it. Pretty easy, right? Yeah. Ooh. The next one. How do you graph the equation? So my starting, well, I'm going to go ahead and just do increments of 1 because it's a small number. 1, 2, 3, 4, go. Set it up. Set it up. All right. So now we're going to start with 7, right? That's y equals mx plus b. We're going to start with 7. That's your starting point right there, which is 0 comma 7. And then my rate of change is the change in y over the change of x, negative 3 over 1, which is going down and then to the right. So down and then to the right. So 1, 2, 3 to the right. One, two, three, to the right, and that's it. And there's my... There you go, there's your arrow. Let's see it. Okay, this is all review. So let's go to the side here. So here we have y is equal to mx plus b, but it's negative 4. So cool, the equivalent, which are equivalent equations to the given y equals mx plus b. So they're all negative 4s, so that's good. But let's see, I need a 3. So what's 6 over 2? I'm going to go ahead and simplify. Please show the work. Don't just do the answers. Show the work, guys. All right? So I could divide by 2, and that's 3 over 1. And 3 over 1 is 3. So, yeah, this one's good. Okay? How about this one? 3 over 9. I could divide by 3, and that'll give me 1 over 3. No, 1 over 3 is not 3. So, nope. How about 2 over 6? Let's see. 2 over 6, I'm going to divide by 2. And that gives me 1 over 3, the same as this one. So no, 1 over 3 is not 3. A lot of students like doing that. I don't know why. They like doing that. So here we go. Oh. Look out. All right, here we go. Showtime. It's math time. It's math time. All right, and then sorry about that. Here we go. And then 9 over 3. Let's go ahead and do 9 over 3. Divide by 3. And that's what? 3 over 1, which is 3. So, yeah, it's this one's the same because see that? 3 over 1 is 3. So there, my answer are A and D. You got that? So if you didn't do it on your own, it's okay. Just follow along. Press pause whenever you want and just do it before I finish the answer and then see if you get it right. All right? Don't just copy to copy. Just copy to understand. All right. And then the next one will go to Mike saved $2 every 3 weeks. He started with $10. Oh, $10. So that's my plus 10. My B is my starting point. And he saved $2 every week. 3 weeks, so 2 over 3x. Got it? Yeah. Ooh, ooh. Ooh, ooh. All right, the next one. Rachel, grandma gave Rachel $15. Every week, Rachel received $3 per week. So this is what she received, so that's what's growing. Her money, $3 every week. So X is every the number of weeks. And she started with 15. Yeah. All right. Next one is 17. Determine the equation. Okay, so I kind of did it for before. So as you notice, it's growing by the fourth. By 4. It's growing by 4, so I'm going to fill in the boxes, right? They have to be orange. So it's adding 4, so we're going to be adding 4. Adding 4. Adding 4. See that? And then what? Then what happens? Boop, boop. Yeah, that's what happens. Havana. So then, what 4 are we adding? We're going to be adding 4 more to this big pattern or figure. All right? And then we're going to add 4 more to the one prior. So we're going to add 4. Okay, so now what's my starting point? My figure 0, right? 0 comma 1, that's plus 1. And my m, my slope, my growth is 4 times x. There it is. So that's your equation. And then it says write an equation for the following. Okay, so we already did that. All right, we're done. That's it. Yeah. All right, so we're done with that. So now this is page 2. This is page 2 of the assessment test. That's page 1. And this is going to be page 2. So I'm going to put page 2. Alright? And then just remember, so now tonight, today, go ahead and do this one. 2-94B. Alright? It's about the patterns. The patterns. Okay? And remember, try to find an equation, which we didn't do. I didn't put, so determine an equation for it, because this is all review. Equation, all right? And then an equation. Forgot to do that for you guys. All right? Write the equation for the given pattern, all right? And remember, the equation is y equals mx plus b. All right, what is it? Y equals mx plus b. All right, there you go. All right, take care. Thank you very much. Have a good day. And please, please turn in your assignment because I'm already starting to count them. All right, I'm starting to count them, and I don't want you guys getting a low grade when we return. All right, so here we go. Adios. Mm-hmm.